baby inside her and the baby died, and now do we have a double homicide? And they're charging that out there. The very same prosecutors that probably would take a pro-choice stance on another day.
Well, how do we know that this woman who was entering the clinic would not have changed her mind,
correct,
would not have left without getting the abortion, and in fact, the action of this protester might have caused the destruction of a life as contemplated by the statute? So the prosecutor might prevail. It might be a homicide.
Very well, but
it could be a homicide. I disagree with this act, and it is a problem. I think it's an act that's been implemented to expand prosecutors' ability to charge people for homicide, and I think that's wrong.
All right. Let me just get back to the reproductive rights question with you, and let me ask you this. Suppose I'm in a relationship with a woman and we talk. She and I have a good, heartfelt discussion, and we have said that we want to have intimacy in our lives, but we don't want to make a baby. And we agree with one another that in the event of a contraceptive failure, that at that point we'll resort to having an abortion as a contraception of last resort. Well, there is a contraceptive failure, a pregnancy does result, and the woman says to me, you know what, I don't think I want to live by my agreement, and you're going to have to pay child support. Is there any way in which a man and woman can make an agreement with one another about their future lives? If she promises one thing, if he promises another thing, is that relevant at all?
Well, legally, I don't think there can be an agreement, but I think you really have got to start meeting new people.
I counsel thousands of men who have been forced into parenthood against their will, who feel they've had no say and no choice, who feel violated in the most fundamental way because it involves sexual intimacy, where the woman had absolute, total control over his life. And my conception of equal partnership is where men and women can have some say over this, over their own lives, and not have the right to force another person to be a parent. That's why I came back to this initial question. Should one person have the right to force another person? And you're saying, I think what you're saying, at least how I interpret it, is that while he should not have the right to force her to be a parent against her will, you're comfortable with her forcing him, even if...
No, I'm not comfortable. From an ethical and moral perspective, I think it's terrible. And I know that some women who want to create more of a commitment from a man get pregnant to do that. I think that's a travesty of that person's character, and I think it's an immoral thing to do. And I think it's wrong, but... I don't think that either person should have control over the other person's reproductive rights. In other words, for example, what if you were in a relationship and a woman said, look, I get, you know, my past experience indicates I get pregnant really easily, but I'd like to have sexual intimacy with you for a variety of reasons. I don't want to marry you at the present time, but for this reason, I'd really love it for you to get a vasectomy so I can be assured that I'm not going to get pregnant. Will you do that? Will you promise to me that you will get a vasectomy?
And I think that's certainly a responsibility a man should have. Suppose he lies.
But should
lies.
A woman be able to force a man to get a vasectomy?
But suppose he says he's going to have a vasectomy.
You haven't answered that.
Should she be able
should
to force him?
Should a woman be
no.
able to force
no.
in the same way right. that he should not be able to force her to get an abortion?
I didn't say he should. I didn't say he should. What I'm saying is that he says to her, do what you want to do with your body and with the pregnancy, but if we've had an agreement not to be parents, don't impose now a responsibility on me. Suppose she lied to him, Deborah. Suppose she said, don't worry, honey, I'm completely protected, and all along it was fraud. All along it was designed
to... This happens,
to...
unfortunately.
And what would the
happens.
Remedy be in that case?
It's an immoral issue. It's an issue of one's morality and character, but men lie to women as well.
So what should the result... They can lie with impunity, with no consequence?
Well, men lie to women too. I mean, that's an unfortunate aspect of relationships. You just have to make better choices with the people and you have sexual relations with.
But there's a remedy here. The remedy is that if a pregnancy results from... And there's been fraud, that Where is it written that because a woman can give birth to a child, she's somehow automatically entitled to have custody of that child? The remedy I'm suggesting is that there are so many people who would take care of that child. There are couples and individuals desperate to adopt. If you say in advance that a woman can commit contraceptive or reproductive fraud and
as
get away
with it,
without consequence, there should be some consequence.
Men have reproductive fraud. They say, I have a vasectomy.
They've never had one.
That's a lie as well. What's a woman to do if she'd never wanted to get pregnant and she has religious reasons for not being able to? You assume that anybody can get an abortion. If someone is a devout Catholic, they cannot get an abortion. That violates their religious rights. What if a Roman says, look, I'm a Roman Catholic, I can't get an abortion. It's just something that I cannot do, or I have medical reasons for why I cannot abort. And a man says, don't worry about it, I have a vasectomy, you'll never get pregnant. And men do this, they lie. Men and women, unfortunately, lie about in intimate situations. And she gets pregnant. What's she going to do?
I think
she
loses
money as a result as well. For her, without marriage, if the man refuses to marry her, it can be immoral or against her religion. It is a travesty on both sides.
Yes, and I think that if people lie to each other, then there are consequences. For example, if you don't tell a partner that you have a sexually transmitted disease, a person gets sick, there should be a cause of action. If you lie about having a vasectomy and it results in tragic consequences for the woman, I would suggest there should be a cause of action. My position here is to try.
But you remember both sides then.
Yeah, I think that what's happened is that reproductive choice has changed profoundly for women. Every woman knows that she can have sex and separate that from procreation.
She can't. Now, I don't know what the
legally
women here,
the law.
No,
Deborah
legally
says,
she can't. She can get pregnant.
But the law
well.
Gives her choices: abortion, adoption, abandoning her child.
You're acting like pregnancy is something that has no bearing on a woman.
We're out of time.
Okay.
Well, otherwise we could go on for this, and maybe Tony will have us back and we'll do this again.
Okay.
But
after the vasectomy, I'm sure.
I have not had a vasectomy. Okay. We're out of time.
I should have brought a condom.
I thank you all for being here and participating in a lively, difficult discussion. Thank you, Tony and Roy, for allowing me to fill in, and thank you especially for watching. We'll see you next time on Men's Night.